Hi, so my name is Kalea and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I want to do a skincare empties type of video. Stuff like products that I enjoyed, products that I want to repurchase, and products that I will not be repurchasing. And yeah, let's just dive right in. So the first brand of products that I want to go over are the Hero Cosmetics products, and I have gone through quite a lot of Hero Cosmetics. So first, I want to talk about their Hero patches. So this patch is the Micro Point for dark spots, the purple one, and this one is the Invisible Mighty patch. I've also had the red one, and I would probably say that I have gone through maybe a total of 3 of these boxes and 2 of the red ones and 2 of these. My favorite are the blue patches, the invisible ones. I feel like they stick better than the original ones to my face. I don't know why. But these, I don't really like these. The dark spot ones, I feel like they don't work. I don't know. I don't really see a difference with these. And I've gone through 2 of these. And they only come with 6. And they're like the same price as this. And I don't think it's worth your money. What I do think is worth your money for Hero is the lightning wand. I feel like the lightning wand works better than this one for dark spots. I do use them together, but like I said, I don't really see a difference with this. But with this, I've gone through a mini one and 2 big sizes. So I've gone through the big size. This is my second one. And I really do like this one. I see a difference. I've used it day and night. Next from Hero is their Rescue Balm. I've gone through 2 of these. This is, or have I gone through 3? 2? 3? I've gone through 2, and I'm almost running out of the second one. So they do have a bigger one, like twice the size. So I'm probably going to pick up one of the big ones. This right here takes care of all your blemishes after you're done with the pimple patch. After you're done with the pimple patch, you just put this on and you're done. It takes care of all of it, and it does help with dark spots. So I really enjoy this. The next products from Hero that I have emptied are the Clear Collective line. This is the jelly cleanser, and this is the toner. So I do have like a little bit left in here, if you can see, I'm not quite sure. But I really did like this. It's simple on the skin? No, it's gentle on the skin. And it exfoliates really well. They do have a new one, their Milky Cleanser. I want to try that one. It's for sensitive skin. I don't think it has sensitive skin, but I do want to give it a try. But these work, that was loud. These work amazingly together in your skincare routine. I did not try the moisturizer because I already have some favorite moisturizers and I didn't want to pick up another one. But yeah, I need to get another one of this and another one of these. I've only gone through 1 bottle, like I said, but I do want to pick up another one, and I highly recommend. Okay, so the next product I want to talk about that I didn't quite empty it, but I don't think I would buy again, are the Revolution skincare pimple patches. I saw this at Target when I was picking up, another one of these. So I saw this at Target, and they're cheaper, and they come with a lot more. They come with like 60, and they're made with salicylic acid. So I thought that was really cool. The only thing is that these don't work as well as the Hero patches. They don't suck up like all the gunk out of your skin. But I spent money on it, so when I run out of my Hero ones, these are the ones I go for. I don't say I would recommend these, but if you're looking for patches on a budget, I wouldn't. But I spent money on this, so I'm going to use it up. The next product that I have gone through is the Milani Makeup Melt. This one, it's empty. I use this whenever I have like heavy makeup on, like a full face of makeup. This is what I use to take off all my makeup. I like it works well, but I don't think I will buy this again because I have other cleansers and makeup removers that I like over this, but this was a good, I liked using it. So next few products that I have emptied are from Bubble Cosmetics. They're one of my favorite skincare brands along with Hero, but the first up I have is the Level Moisturizer. Level Up Moisturizer, I have gone through two of these. I've gone through two of these. I have a backup one under my sink right now, but this one is more of a, this moisturizer is a gel moisturizer, and so it's good for oily skin, which I do have. I have combination skin, so it's more oily than dry, but it's dry sometimes. But this moisturizer is amazing. Next is their Fresh Start Gel Cleanser. I have gone through the full size bottle of this and the mini one. So I got the mini one for traveling, and I do not have the full size with me, like the emptied full size. The full size is on my sink in my bathroom, but this cleanser is, it doesn't like foam up, so it's good for like all skin types. I like it because it's gentle and it does exfoliate my skin as well. And Bubble also comes with like these cute little stickers to decorate your products with. Oop, the lighting is terrible. If I do it like that. Anyway. Next is their toner. So this is the Bubble Bounce Back Refreshing Toner. I like this toner because it's a spray bottle. Oh, there's product in it? I thought you were empty. Anywho, that was funny. This is a spray toner, so I don't have to use a cotton pad when I use this. I just spray it on my face and pat it in and let it sit on the skin for like 30 seconds or so. I've gone through two of these. This one's empty, and the one in my bathroom is currently like running low, and I do have a third one under my sink, a replacement. I love this toner so much. It's great. They also have another toner. It's their Break Even Toner. I ran out of that one as well. I like this one better, more because of the way you use it. The other one, you have to use a cotton pad, and I don't like using cotton pads, so I like the spray one better. So the next Bubble product that I have gone through is their Come Clean Clay Mask. It is completely gone through. I have another one in my sink. On my sink, and I have another one coming in the mail because I needed a backup. This clay mask is amazing. It it's not thick and it doesn't dry out your skin like I thought it would. Excuse me, because typically clay masks dry out your skin, but this one does not. And I like to use it maybe once, two times a week if I don't forget. But mainly I use it to like spot conceal. I have a pimple right here that I was using these Revolution patches to help get rid of, but this one does a good job to take out the impurities in your skin when you're like having pimples, or it also helps with dark spots. So this is what I also like to use this one for. So next is not really skincare, but it goes with like kind of skincare. It's kind of skincare, not really, but you know, you wouldn't find this in the skincare aisle. But this is the Milani Rose Lip Balm. This one, it's completely empty. Like, it's gone all the way. It keeps going. Yeah, there. And it's gone all the way up. There's no more. I can't get it. This is my second container of this, and I want to get another one. But this lip balm I replaced with this lip balm. This is a more pigmented lip balm. They're kind of the same color. But this one I use every day. But this one I bought first, and it's really hydrating. And what I love about this is that it transforms the pigment in your skin. So it's like pink, but on my lips it turns like a darker rosy pink, kind of similar to this color, but not as deep. And I use this, I used it just for like everyday lip balm. It's really, really good. But if you are looking for more pigment and different colors, I would highly recommend the Milani lip balm, like the Fetish lip balm ones. These are amazing, and they feel really comfortable and on the lips, and they're just like, oh, chef's kiss. Milani's lip products are amazing. I have so many over there in my little makeup container, but this balm. The next skincare products in my little bucket here are products that I probably will not be repurchasing, or things like I did not really like. So the first one is this moisturizer. It's not even empty. This is the Neutrogena moisturizer. I bought this way before I was introduced to Bubble and Hero. I liked it back then because it was cheap and it worked on my skin, but I don't like the scent. It's just the pink grapefruit one. I don't like it because of the scent and sometimes it would tingle, but I did like that it had salicylic acid and it was an acne treatment. That was mainly what I was looking for in a moisturizer. Any skincare products were acne treatment and salicylic acid because I did have a lot of acne in high school. But the Hero and Bubble products really helped me with my acne and I don't break out as much. These Freeman masks, I have the clay ones and some peel off ones, and I got these ones in a set that I haven't used. I used the orange one, but I haven't used the blue ones. And I also have another clay mask. This is the mud one, the detoxifying mud one. I do like this. I will use this, but I haven't used it in a while because I've been stuck on my bubble clay mask. But before then, I bought I was getting ready to go to college, I bought a pack from Amazon of these, and I did like them at first. And I will say I like the peel off ones more than the clay ones because I feel like the Freeman clay mask dried out my skin, but the peel off ones, I really did see a difference. But will I repurchase them? I don't think so, because these are big and I still have a lot in here. They're sitting like in the back, they sit in the back of here under my sink, and I don't reach for them. I don't know why. But I recommend this one, but not the others. So the next skincare product that I don't recommend, or that I will not be repurchasing because I don't reach for it, is this Differin Detox and Soothe 2-in-1 Treatment Mask. I got this mainly because it was on sale. It has, like I said, it's a 2-in-1, and one side is a clay, if you can see it. The lighting is terrible. I dropped it. YouTube is just a lot. But one side is a clay. Yeah, this is a clay mask, and this side heats up while the gel side soothes your skin. I like the clay. I mean, I like the gel. It's really soothing and calming and cool on your skin, but I feel like the clay, the side that heats up a lot, heats up too much, and I don't really like that. It feels uncomfortable on my skin. And you're only supposed to use it for 3 minutes, so I did only use it for 3 minutes, but I just didn't reach for it. I stopped using it, but I spent a lot of money on it, so I think I might use it again. I'm not quite sure. It was a lot of money, so I might. So the last two products I want to talk about are from The Ordinary. So this is The Ordinary Salicylic Mask, 2% mask. I bought this in a set that came with a cleanser and a moisturizer. I didn't like the cleanser. The moisturizer was eh. The moisturizer was like simple. It didn't really do anything. It just sat there. I don't reach for this anymore. I don't think I will. So that goes in there. And this is The Ordinary AHA 30% plus BHA 2% peeling solution. When I first started using this, it worked really well on my skin, and I don't know, I just stopped using it. I have like that much left. That's a lot. I should use this because I saw a video on TikTok, and she mentioned, like, one girl mentioned this. Some question was like, how do you get your skin so smooth and bright? And she was like, oh, I use this. And I said, I have this. Why don't I use this? I don't know. I just stopped using it for some reason. But you're supposed to use this once to twice a week, depending on how sensitive your skin is, and you're supposed to build up to use it even more. And you're only supposed to use it for 10 minutes on your skin. I use it for like 5 to 8 minutes, not really 10. This, when I was using it, I accidentally put it on like an open wound, like an open pimple, and it burned my skin so badly, and I kind of got scared of using it. So whenever I used it, I was really careful of and blah, blah, blah. So when I was using this, I was really careful about my pimples, and I think that's why I stopped using it. But I don't know, my sister can't use that because her skin is more sensitive than mine and it burns her, so she doesn't really like to use that. But yeah, I think that is everything in my skincare empties, or products that I recommend and would definitely buy again, and products I have like gone through. Yeah, so my top brands from here are Bubble. I do have a skincare code with them. I'll put it on the screen or in the description. And then Hero Cosmetics is one of my favorite brands as well. I am an ambassador for both of them. So this video is not sponsored or anything. I just truly love these products and they are what works best on my skin. And yeah. Okay, so that's it for my empties video. If you enjoy skincare and you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Comment down below your favorite skincare brands and you know what works for your skin. I want to like talk in the comments about that. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I will link my other skincare videos either up in this little corner or down below. I do have a skincare playlist that you can watch. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. I should do a thumbnail. This is not as heavy as I thought it would be. Is this good? Yeah. Yeah, I think that's good. Wait, let me touch the screen. There we go. That's better. This is so funny. That's weird. Okay, I'm done.